This is Eric from Axis. Today we talk about using setup sheets. So you've just finished programming and posting your part. Now you need to communicate with your operator some basic setup information. The part I just finished has multiple setups, but for this video we'll focus on operation one. However, you could create a separate setup sheet for each operation by repeating the steps we're talking about in this video. After selecting setup sheets from the drop-down in the Operations Manager, an information menu pops up on your screen. This menu allows the programmer to add a project name, the customer the project's for, who did the programming, when it was programmed, even revisions to the program. Images are ticked, allowing the image in the MasterCam geometry field to be included in the setup sheet. I'm also going to include the operations working coordinate system, and the programmer can control the order in which the tools are displayed in the setup sheet, ascending, descending, none, or default. MasterCam has included several different setup sheet templates. To access these options, simply select F2 and another pop-up window will appear with different setup sheets and template options. Make your selection, hit the green check. After all your choices have been made, select the green check and Active Reports pulls the required information from MasterCam and launches the setup sheet. Active Reports pulled all the data the programmer added to the information menu and displayed the data in the title block of the setup sheet. Active Reports also grabbed the image from the current image in MasterCam and pulled the comments from the stock setup area in your program, then added all this to the setup sheet. Page 2 of the setup sheet starts with the total cycle time of the complete operation. It also has an operations list with each tool number, minimum Z, maximum Z, and cycle time broke down. Page 3 of the setup sheet starts your tool list. This is where having your own tool library, a tool library that you made for your company, really starts to pay off because, as you can see, I have little graphical representations of each of the cutters used in this operation. If you look a little bit deeper, I also have holder callouts, I also have cutter callouts, I have catalog codes, I have work offsets, I have length offsets, I have everything included into this. That's really a time saver. Well, after you get done and you want to save this, you literally go back into File, decide how you want to save it. There's multiple ways. I generally save mine as a PDF because I keep it in my file folder with all my NC. Select PDF, select a name for your setup sheet, hit Save, say OK. And that's all there is to it.